James, where in the hell are we at today?
You took me to a dump.
You know, we are at the dump, and if you look right over here, what you're gonna see is we're at the dump. So what the hell, what are we doing at the dump, James?
We're looking for the Butterfield stage line.
At the dump?
At the dump.
Well,
outside of Gila Bend.
Good luck. Isn't it unbelievable that on the way down to Gila Bend that this old remnants of this building, which used to be where the stage stop was, that people came here on the way to the west? You know, one thing that's really incredible about this is you kind of get your mind to step back is that we know for sure stagecoaches came right in front of this building and went through that front door. We know that to be a fact. And look at these trucks that are going by. This trash truck's over here. I mean, they're everywhere and it's nonstop. But this old building still stands. And this was the stagecoach stop. You know, one of the most incredible things about this cactus is it actually saw those wagon trains run up to the front of that building for those passengers. And can you imagine what it was like to finally get to this spot and to be able to get out of that thing after being beat to death all the way up through Maricopa, and how difficult of a journey that would be? And we're not even into Gila Bend yet. You know, the Sonoran Desert is absolutely gorgeous. And we're here at one of the stops along the route to Gila Bend. Now, what makes this intriguing is De Anza, the Spaniard, came down this trail in 1775 and 1776. And then the Mormon Battalion came through here in about 1846. And then the Overland Stage was 1858 to 1869. So this has been a major traffic fair all the way through to the West Coast, north, south, all the way to Mexico. And the Sonoran Desert is just gorgeous all the way through as you go through here. It's a beautiful place and you should enjoy it.
Who's that?
Oh, hell, looks like it's John. Cool.
Nice.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, buddy, what's going on? Where are you?
Well, we are making a run down to Gila Bend.
Oh, man, you still chasing those ruins and petroglyphs and stuff?
Absolutely. That's where we're heading today. Hey.
All right, well, hey, I got an idea. You know, when you get to Gila Bend, if you get heading off on 85 up to Gillespie Dam, there's a nice set of petroglyphs up there just north of the dam. Does that interest you?
Absolutely. So, you know, I think I read something about those. I think I read, didn't they have some maybe graffiti problems up there?
You know, I can't be sure. I haven't been up there in a while, but, you know, I remember when I was up there, they were really pretty interesting stuff. I could send you the coordinates if that interests you.
Yeah, because, you know, they're trying to make that area a monument area. And, you know, it might help to be able to go up there and shoot them to help them be able to get that land put away. Do me a favor. Give me the coordinates. Hell yes. Well, you know, run up there, James?
Yeah, we should definitely do that today. That sounds like a good plan.
Yeah. Let's do it.
All right. Listen, I'll send you the coordinates, but listen, they're not perfect, but they're right in the area. You follow those coordinates, you'll be right in the ballpark, okay?
Right on, man. I appreciate you, John. Thank you.
Thanks, John.
All right, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.
See you. Bye. Oh, hell, those would be awesome.
That's perfect.
Yeah, let's go ahead and do that.
Need to do that.
Yeah, we'll run up that way.
All right, like I said, just up to 85. So.
Yeah, so perfect. So
it's coming up.
Cool.
Good deal.
Bam! Bam!
Cool. Let's see what we find. So what is that smell, dude?
Well, I'm going to tell you what. That's, I think it's Hickman eggs. I think it's Hickman eggs.
I'm pretty sure that's chickens, right?
It's terrible. That is like horrible.
We were like,
I thought maybe James had some gas. I'm just going, and he probably thought I had some gas.
I was giving him.
I was like, I ain't saying nothing.
On our way in, I thought maybe he had left a hard-boiled egg in the cooler from the other day, and so you know. But it turns out there is a giant chicken farm. It's so bad that like we were several miles away and you could smell it up on the cliffs.
What, 12 or 13 miles?
Yeah, 12 or 13 miles away. More than 10 miles.
And you can still smell it. So I understand why these people are a little sideways down here for sure. You know, as I'm sitting here, I'm compelled to say that we've got to save this area because I look out in this open area, how beautiful this really is. And that, you know, so many people are moving to Phoenix, which, you know, it is what it is. But if you want your children to have places to go, if you decided that you want to be a Arizonian or a Phoenician and you've put your roots here, most likely your family is going to be here. And, you know, let's preserve this for our children. You know, let's make sure it's here for them and the next generation after that. This is one of the most beautiful states anywhere, you know, and let's preserve it. Let's do the right thing and let's put this land away and protect it. I'm just compelled to say that because it's so beautiful out here. And I feel so fortunate that we get to come out here and experience this. And I'd hate that anything would ever happen to it. Okay, here we go again. Here's our version of American Picker. Here looks like an oil can.
Oh.
With 76. Looks like it says 76 on it, doesn't it?
Sort
of. That's kind of a cool can.
That is neat.
I can't really. You could probably read. I'm not sure what it is.
What's it there, say on the top?
Was there lettering?
Some kind of marking on it.
Oh, SAE. It is oil. Oil can. It is an oil can. So somebody had
it. Oh, there it is. There's the mark. I can see it in the sun. That is a 76 can.
Wow.
Cool, man.
That actually is kind of neat. So here we are. It's James. You know, we found the trail coming up. So what it looks like is this. Unless you want to see that little guy over there, then go on to the edge in between these two cliff faces here and here. And there's a trail. You see it right there. And that saved a little time, a little energy. As we come up here, now a lot of people, I think, go to that road and then do goggles or
binoculars.
But we don't do no binoculars.
There's the star, there's the centipede. There's the sun.
Now they're supposed to be spectacular petroglyphs, so that's what we're looking for. Spectacular, and some of the largest in the state of Arizona are supposed to be up here.
There's a sun, very similar to the one we've seen. We got our traditional lizards. Cowboy.
Where?
Scratched in. Actually kind of nice.
Over here. Get up in this mess. Take a look.
This is a really cool rock formation.
Where's the cowboy, James?
To your left. Straight ahead at you. See him?
No.
It kind of looks like Jacob Waltz, right there, literally to your right. See where your camera's at? You're pointing right at him. No, left, right there.
Oh, right there. Kind of looks like a, yes.
Looks like the portrait of him at the Duke Mint Museum.
It's got a name in there. Get over in here.
You know, it's pretty cool out, but these rocks get hot quick.
I'll tell you what, this black rock is.
We're out of the bad season, and it's still hot on these rocks.
Area. I tell you what, the wall is beautiful, regardless of what else is in it. The wall is beautiful. Not a lot. And you're like, those guys stood here. And they stood on these rocks, stood on this ground, this very ground, and beat on this very rock. And that's pretty fascinating to me, that knowing that they were standing here. Whether it be that stagecoach that pulled up in front of that station house, or, you know, it's, you know, the fact they were up here doing this work, it's pretty incredible, it really is. See, these look a lot different from over here. You get a lot better look. Oh, there's the big one there to your left, James. You see that big panel? Right there to your left. Over, one more panel. Those zigzags, those pattern pieces. Now, that is one thing, I didn't see them as well because I was so close. But here we go. Here's another sun. I saw a hole in a rock right there too. So take a look at it when you come across. There's a sun. It's a nice sun right there. There's a pea. I don't know if that's a pea or that's, you know, somebody's initial or it was a symbol of some type. It looked like it had. Make sure you get a shot of that. I was going to, and for some reason I walked on. So, you know, an ancient stood up right up there. Isn't that cool? You know, he stood up on this block here. He stood on this block here. And carved these. And that's kind of the cool part too, as you know, they were up here standing on these very rocks looking over that field, and you know, they were up here. And like I said, we've seen a lot of these from people taking pictures or binoculars down there, but I haven't seen any crazy people up here. But you know, it's not like some of the ones we've been in lately where the fall would be. Now again, that could still kill you, but not. Now we'll also catch these as we climb down and around and see if they look a little different from a little distance, because we were right up on them. But the cool thing is, to me, is when you're down here and you see this here and you're like, those guys stood here and they stood on these rocks, stood on this ground, this very ground, and beat on this very rock. You want this one?
I can stick with this guy.
You have this one, it goes way back in there.
Okay.
You may want to, I got it in there.
Okay, let's try. You shoot me now.
Make sure I'm on. Go ahead and put it on and we'll go from there. And I'll shoot you with this one. Getting in there. Now I'm gonna have James get up in there. Now I got where my arm was in there, but can you slip in there a little tighter even?
Ooh.
Yeah, it goes way back. I'm just saying, that could be something. It goes to the right up in there.
Yeah.
And so I'm just like, I got up in there to. So somebody was jacking around here in 1926, James. hard to see what's this little amphitheater type area. Okay, James, here's where we do a
talk.
Shoot me from down there up here.
I'm gonna bite my face. Oh, dude, it's kind of like the Apache Death Cave, but too small for a person after you get up.
Here, throw this, put this up in there, see, because, you know, maybe later we'll even look and see that there's something in there that, you know, big old pot in there. Then we have to figure out a way to come back and get it.
Pretty cool.
That's pretty awesome. Then that way,
I'm
there's
way up in this thing. Nice. Spider babies. This is definitely where the black widows are making babies. Do you want me to go further?
If you can, if you can just see what you can see physically. Let me get out here where I can shoot you.
I think they're dead down to your right. I think we would have walked all the way around the ones I just saw.
You know, everything down here is going to be on a pretty rocky, not that that's bad actually, but there's no trails. Well, here's the deal. Ain't no reason for both of us till we know for sure. Why don't you go left and I'll go right. You go down.
Give you an idea of what we just came through to get here. It's worth it, because look at that guy.
Well, this was the area, wasn't it?
Looks like it.
You know, we saw a lot of stuff from people down there on the road, but I haven't seen any up here. Look at there.
Those hands. Nice.
Nice. What are those Rosales?
Oh, that's for a reason. That's from a paint pen. That's not cool. Don't do that.
Well, that's one of the reasons we got to get these videos out and let people know.
I don't really want to tell people what to do, but that's not cool.
Big hands.
Big hands.
Big hands, no feet.
Make a big hands for us.
Big hands. Look at that
big
beautiful.
Big hands, no feet.
Yeah, big hands, no feet.
You'd have to watch our last episode to know what that reference is.
One of the
so you should do that. One and of like and subscribe while you're at it.
Yeah, one of the 44 people. I don't know on that one. I'm not sure. That's an old. Those look old right there. That doesn't look.
Yeah, those actually look like old enough and worn down so much you can barely miss them out.
Tell you what, this
four,
is.
Four attempts that were abandoned. Whoa.
Got a loose rock. Look at this.
James wall. Almost dead.
We ain't going James down yet today, James.
Not yet. I gotta get
now, these are a little looser up in this.
Jay Shrek wants me to get more footage before I'm allowed to die.
No dying. We're not there yet.
Make sure he has a camera before I fall.
Oh, that would suck. Look at this wall. Dude. This wall alone is worth the trip.
Oh, look at that. There's some deer.
Those alone are worth the trip. Now look at what we're walking across.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
This is hairy.
Give you an idea how
Here's James coming up. Now, this looked like the way that the ancients would have come up this, because there definitely looks like a trail. But is there a second place to get? Now, this looks like it's not bad right here to your right. Now, go to your left over here. Left. I think it's over here. Your left, yeah. Oh, see that little crack in there?
Yeah, okay.
That looks like it.
I overstepped. Yeah. Gotcha. I'm good.
Here, if you need a hand. If you get where you need to, grab it. Just, I'm just going to make sure I'm wedged in there.
I had my pack on, so I had to keep my weight forward.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Look at that.
What'd you do?
I don't know. I don't know what happened there.
I should have been the one that got hurt there.
I was climbing. I think I just got a...
Oh, it was that one bush down
there. The bush down there got me. So, well, that's pretty intriguing right there.
That was fun.
I thought that was a way. You know, though, when I saw it, I'm like, okay, that's a trail out of here. That's a trail out of here.
Oh, yeah.